Welcome to Hansen Island, a remote place on the west coast of Canada, about 10 kilometers long and 2 kilometers wide. This island belongs to two groups, the First Nations and the Orca. For most of my life, I've had the great good fortune of living here in this incredible environment and studying this incredible creature. And it's given me a sense of peace in the world. I want everybody to have that same experience. My name is Paul Spong, and 47 years ago, I was a young scientist at the University of British Columbia, and part of my job was to study an orca in captivity at the Vancouver Aquarium. I came to understand that orcas are acoustic creatures because they're using sound to locate their prey. They get what they need to live from sound. They should not be penned up in concrete tanks that deprive them of the sound of the ocean that they were born into. Ultimately, that knowledge led me to search for a place in the wild where I could study orcas, totally without interfering with them. And that search led me to Hansen Island, where I set up Orca Lab. We built a network of half a dozen hydrophones that cover 50 square kilometers of the surrounding area. And they give us live audio so we can track their movements, often 24 hours a day.
61 and 60 are right there.
Yeah. For me, one of the greatest experiences here is putting on a pair of earphones and just listening. And then we have speakers in the forest, near the tents, near the outhouse, near the camp kitchen, all of the spaces around here. One of the things you can't help noticing and feeling is the sudden intrusion of a boat, of a vessel, of a propeller. It's jarring. Here at Orca Lab, we listen to untold quantities of boat noise. It's really annoying. We can always walk away from it, but whales can't. It disrupts their communication. It disrupts their ability to hunt.
We've had quite a few breaches as well. Uh-huh.
I think from a point of view of the welfare of the whales, something that has to be dealt with. What I want to do is develop the ability for people to get to feel empathy for the creature. Since 2000, we've streamed live audio so that anybody with computer access to the internet can listen to exactly what we listen to in our lab.
Oh, look, it's right up at the...
What we're trying to do is give people a taste of what it is to be an orca in this magnificent environment. In doing that, they will come to care and want to protect nature. I believe that if I can share what I have experienced, the world could know peace.